Let's play on Lenovo Legion Go the game FIFA 25. Here I have the game running at this point with some incredible graphics. Immediately I will show you the settings: 1920 by 1200 medium graphics, 60 frames, huge display, the perfect device to have this game.
To bring you live match commentary, and my expert analyst, as always on these occasions, is Stuart Robson. And it's the opening contest for the two teams in this Champions League season. How's it going to go, Stuart?
I'm looking forward to this one, Derek. It's so important we get off to a good start. So let's hope both sides go for the win here and we get an exciting match. Well, when you play in a 3-5-2 formation, the position of the wing-back
might be a chance here. And a goal it is! No long wait for the opener today.
Well, as you can see, the defending is all over the place. That's far too easy for the attackers. The goalkeeper's got absolutely no chance there.
So let me show you the settings. As I said at this point, this is the best experience ever on a handheld device. Huge resolution, 1920 by 1200. As you know, on Asus ROG Li or Li X, you can go up to 1920 by 1080 on a smaller display. Here we can go to 1920 by 1200. We can go even higher at 1600, 2560 by 1600 if you accept lower frame rate. At this point I have medium quality selected for the game, and with this kind of setup for the settings, I have 60 frames. So let's continue.
Possession. Can he put it in? needs to work out for them. And in the second time of asking, it's a goal. The keeper, meanwhile, looks to the heavens.
Well, here's the replay. Yes, it's a decent shot, but the goalkeeper has to do a lot better then. He's parried it out into a dangerous area, and suddenly the ball's in the back of his net. It's poor goalkeeping, you have to say. So back underway, with the lead standing at 2-0. Perfect challenge. Well, I'm hearing there's been a goal in one of the other games, and Alex Scott can fill us in. Thanks for the update, Alex. Havertz. Just have to make sure they don't get caught on the counter-attack. Martinelli. Watch how he goes past his man with such ease, and it's just a change of pace. And when he gets up to it, he holds off the challenge, keeps his balance, and makes good contact with the ball. That's a top-class finish.
And he's going to go back and issue a caution here.
Well, the referee wasn't going to forget that, was he?
The action, and Arsenal sprinting away with ease. Totalling up all the stoppages, we'll have two additional minutes. Textbook closing down, and now they're on the attack. So the whistle then, we're up the halfway stage in this match. A really dominant performance so far from Kai Havertz. Off and running again as we reflect upon an eye-catching first half display from Arsenal.
Well, here we can see it again. Look at the way he glides past the defender to create space for himself. And then the strike from Saka. He never really looked like missing, did he? Brilliant finish.
And this is turning into something of a rout. 4-0. Can he find the right pass? Kai Havertz. And the referee playing advantage. Decides to shoot. And he's tipped it out. Fully stretched. Somehow reaching it. Referee deciding to let the play flow, but now it will be a booking, Stuart.
Well, as soon as the ball went dead, he was always going to book it, and he's absolutely right to do so.
And time for the change now. Elects to go short. Corner once more. played over. That's very decisive goalkeeping. Looking to cut inside. And the keeper taking care of the situation. And new developments I'm hearing at the Parc des Princes with the information. Here's Alex.
Yes, another goal for PSG. They pulled one back with 61 minutes played.
Thanks as always to Alex Scott. He has teammates around him. Well, nothing comes of it. It looked promising. Just 20 minutes remaining now. It's not going to go down as the prettiest passing sequence we've ever seen.
Taken their goal well, but the defending was non-existent. That should never happen.